The desegregation decisions and other type of legislation and Supreme Court decisions depends upon changing the white man's mind. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us that our own mind has to be changed. We have to change our mind about ourselves.
In what way?
Well, so he teaches us the importance of moral reformation, a knowledge of self. And for instance, the average so-called Negro, he doesn't think that he can go into business and provide jobs for himself. And because of this, he thinks that he can only get a job from the white man, or he can only get clothes from the white man, or he can only get food from the white man. And we who follow the Honorable Elijah Muhammad are taught that the same thing that the white man has done for himself and his kind, if our people could be if we could be cured of our slave mentality that was indoctrinated into us during slavery, we would realize that just as the white man can do these things for himself and his kind, we can get together in unity and harmony and do the same thing for ourselves and our kind. The white man brainwashed the so-called Negro to the point of believing in white supremacy so much that today some Negroes think that they're not making progress or they don't have anything unless they're living in a white neighborhood, unless they have the white man's neighborhood, a seat in the white man's school, or a position on the white man's job, and they even have taken it so far they don't think they're successful in life unless they have a white woman as a wife.